Hello there, guys and girls, and everything that's in between, and welcome to another episode of Hearthstone Wednesdays. Today we're going to play a little bit of Arena. I'm probably going to do a draft, two games, and then three games every episode. So, yeah, let's do this. New season in Hearthstone, which is fine and dandy. I finished rank 6 last time, which is kind of a bummer, because I kind of stayed on 5 so long, then I kept bouncing back and forth. Mage is best arena class, in my opinion. I'm going to grab Mage, and hopefully we get some good cards. Big Game Hunter over the other two. Obvious choice is obvious. Silverhand Knight is better than the other two as well. Chilwindietti, yes. Scarlet Crusader or Silvermoor Guardian. Silver Moon Guardian. Scarlet Crusader is a little bit better. Hello, Ventrico. Ventrico is fantastic. Pretty bad picks here. I think I'm gonna go with the Tidehunter. This is another hard call. Frostwolf Warlord is... it's kind of good in aggro decks, but I don't really have the things for it. A Youthful Brewmaster could be good with the Big Game Hunter and even the Murloc Tidehunter here. And even the Silverhand Knight. Wow, okay. Youthful Brewmaster it is. Mirror Entity is the worst pick here. Arcane Intellect. It's between Arcane Intellect and Spiteful Smith. I already have 2 5 drops, so I'm gonna pick an Arcane Intellect for card draw. Man. I mean, Ironforge Rifleman is pretty terrible. It's made less terrible in Mage because you can do one more damage, so it can kill a 2-health minion with your hero power for 5 mana and have a body on the board. But compare it to something like Stampeding Kodo, which does kill a minion and then has such better stats, so I'm just going to go with Mirror Image. Who knows what we get here. Another pretty bad pick. Most likely going to be Arcane Golem, just because he can do 4 damage for 3 mana. Another Chilwindietti is just fantastic. I need some spells. I need to start drawing some spells. Nerubian Egg and Imp Master, as well as Twilight Drake, are all terrible in Arena. The best one is most likely going to be Imp Master. Wow, really bad picks here. Argent Squire, a little bit better. Jungle Panther, starting to look like a rush deck. Finally, something nice. A Flame Strike. It's really, really important. A Fireball. That's really, really important. Budibe Bodyguard is not... It's slightly worse than average, in my humble opinion. Arcane Explosion is kind of okay in Mage, actually. I guess I just take it and pray for a Mana Worm. Dark Iron Dwarf over Fairy Dragon because, I don't know, I kind of need 2 drops here. I'm going to risk it. Another Arcane Intellect, so now we have nice card draw. Blizzard is good, so we have 2 board clear. Frost Elemental is nice for the freeze. Iron Beak Owl. People say it's not good in Arena, but from my experience, it's actually pretty good. 3 drops, we have an Arcane Golem, which isn't really something that you can play comfortably on turn 3. An Imp Master, which is kind of okay. And then these 2 guys, so we do have pretty good 3 droppage. Know about the Iron Fur Grizzly, a duplicate might actually be the best pick here. Frostbolt over Spellbreaker, because he costs too much to get a silence. I might pick another Ventrico Mercenary here, but I'm desperately in need of low drops. Look, I only have 1, 2, 3. So I definitely need smaller guys. Picking the Assassin. Direwolf Alpha is actually good for us here. Wow, this is really terrible. 3 mana 4/3 is not bad. Bloodsail Corsair is obviously shit. But with the one, with the 2 hit points, 1 mana is it, I don't know. It's good in specific situations. Mana Wraith is just, I think that's a second or third Mana Wraith we get. So I might be forced to pick an Injured Blade Master here. We got two more. Undertaker, Zombie Chow, or Gnomish Inventor. We have enough draw. I think Zombie Chow is an easy choice here. Wow, Knife Juggler is a great way to finish this. Now, it is kind of lacking in spells. We only have one Fireball and two AoE cards like Blizzard and Flamestrike. No Polymorph, unfortunately, but we do have the Big Game Hunter, which is a nice kind of... Nice card to have in arena sometimes, because you never know, you can have crazy shit. So here we go. Let's go and start getting some wins. Yes, that's it. Winnage is always nice. Right, here we are. So it's going to be against a Paladin. This is a really nice card to have against Paladin. I'm gonna mulligan you, and I'm gonna mulligan you too. Come on, Argent Squire! Nope, not today. Maybe now? Maybe now, Argent Squire? Nope. Nice card though. Alright, so, oh, I need to change my card back to the new Goblins and Gnomes card pack. Oh wow, Zombie Chow at the beginning. What a strong play. I'm gonna play the Youthful Brewmaster as opposed to the Knife Juggler because I don't want to lose my Knife Juggler to a Zombie Chow. His name is Peel! Fairy Dragon. Okay, do I want to lose the Knife Juggler or do I draw? I don't have a way to deal with the Fairy Dragon next turn. And my 4 drop is most definitely going to be a Chillwind Yeti. So I need this guy on the board, unfortunately. So he's gonna buff it. Does he go for face here? Wow, okay. Coin into humility? Blessing of wisdom. Okay. I'm gonna play my Yeti. Hopefully it hits the Shattered Sun Cleric. Oh wow, wonderful. Okay. I'll give him a card. The only way he can really kill it right now is if he does weapon. Just gonna go for face. No problems. We're gonna ping here. Do I draw or do I play a... Do I play my board out? If I play my board out, he can clear everything with Consecration. And I'll have an Argent Squire left. I'm gonna take that chance, because if he doesn't, then we're in a really good position. We can always draw out of this place too with Arcane Intellect, because I don't think he can beat us on board presence right now without Consecration. Did he draw into... He drew into consecration. What a joke. Okay. That's not a problem. Gonna draw some cards. Play the zombie chow. Alright, so this is a decent position. I can't believe he drew into the consecration. Oh my god. Okay. Sunwalker. Should I be concerned? Oh wow. I can draw again. But I don't think that's the play. I actually think the play here is... I attack the Sunwalker with the Argent Squire. Or I can ping and then trade these two into it if I buff with the Dark Iron Dwarf, but that's not full usage of mana. So yeah, I think this is the best play. If I ping, play this guy, I have two left. Oh man, this is a tough place to be in. Yeah, I think this is... It's kind of painful, but I kind of need to do it. He top decked into the Sunwalker, which is really good too. Let's see what he top decks this time. And if he actually plays the card, he top decks again. Give me a quest. Okay, questing adventure is not super great. Unless he Blessing of Kings it. Okay, he doesn't. That's a pretty good play. Wow, okay. This is starting to look scary now. This is when we top deck the Consecration or the Blizzard. How about that? One for one, buddy. One for one. Stranglethorn Tiger. He's going to continue to buff the shit out of his questing adventures. I think it might be questing adventures. Questing adventurer. Oh, what a draw. What a draw. So we go here. We hit, we ping, and then we Silverhand Knight. Yeah, that looks good. Look at this. We're doing well, we're doing well. And we still have Arcane Intellect if we get pushed in the corner. Oh, he has a Silverhand Knight too, okay. To the Battle of the Knights! How does he do this? He obviously hits my Silverhand with his, okay. Oh my god. Okay. Was that really needed? Let's see. Well, this has to happen. No doubt in mind. Can we kill something while still... Can we... Okay, so right now I can clear the board and be left with a 2-1 squire. If I play my Direwolf... if I play my Direwolf, oh man, rough stuff. He's gonna have 10 mana anyway next turn, so you can have an extra mana crystal. I'm gonna trade here, and then yeah, I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna hit here. I'm gonna draw. Wow, okay, that's a really nice draw. I'm gonna keep these in my hand for now. I'm not gonna play the Bloodfen Raptor or the Direwolf Alpha. If he has Consecration now, he plays it. Okay, he has Guardian of Kins. That's fine. That's fine. Plays a Cobra, that's also fine. We're fine. We're solid. We're golden. We are golden. We ping here. Trade. We trade. We play the Injured Blade Master, he can survive at Consecration, and we again hold on to the cards. There's no reason to overextend here. We have 12 to his 14 cards, okay. So he's gonna play a little dude, and he's gonna Equality. Wow, okay. quality consecrate? No? Who's he gonna... Right. Right. Well, this guy's gonna die anyway. There's no way to save this guy. So I'm gonna trade here. Ping. Play the Yeti. And, he has one card now. He's gonna be top decking for days. So... Does he go face? No. Okay. Ping and play that. Yeah, I think we have this game. I hope we have this game. This is Hearthstone. You never have a game. He plays a dude and he buffs it with Stormwind Champion. Okay. I wish he had one more attack. That would have been amazing. Okay, so how do we deal with this? Oh, what's the best way to deal with this? I mean, I can kill it by losing the Yeti, and then I can ping the... His top ticks have been golden. I can kill this by sacrificing my Yeti. Alternatively, which is I think what I'm going to do is... I'm gonna ping here, I'm gonna Imp Master, I'm gonna taunt... I'm gonna ping face, and I'm gonna hit this guy here. Just don't top deck consecration again, bro. Don't do it. Okay, that's totally acceptable. Totally acceptable. We are fine. We are totally fine. Do I hit there? Yeah, I think I do. Hit there. And then I, let's see. I do this. Yeah. And then there. And I freeze him in case he draws a weapon. And I get more minions. So I'm playing this very, very patiently and trying to be as safe as I can. It's because if I've learned anything from playing this game a lot, it's that you're better safe than sorry almost always. So there we go. Trade. Panther. Attack. So next turn we have lethal. Okay, good game. All right, so first game, first win. Oh, look at this value. Dalaran Gold Mage. Can you handle? Can you handle the man from Aladdin with the shiny blue sphere on his head? Let me tell you now, you cannot handle him. Oh, we have a Spellmaster quest. Okay. First win. Game number two of the video, which is the last game. So yeah, we'll do three videos at a time. Or three games at a time. Yeah, that's what I meant. But this video got a game discount because of the draft. Game number two against Anduin. Priest. The light shall bring victory. I definitely don't like playing against Priest. But with this hand, I think I'm okay with anything. Wow. Okay. Solid. Solid stuff here. Do you see the combos that are setting up? Do you see the combos we're getting? You play a zombie Chow turn one, you follow up with a knife juggler, and then hopefully you get another two drop, then you play the youthful brewmaster to return the probably hurt Chow to your hand, and then you play him again to do damage. It's great. It's great. Money knives will be juggled this day. Oh yeah, that is. Oh. Okay. Maybe we're gonna have to actually trade the zombie chow in. Yeah. We will trade the zombie chow in. Next turn though, we coin into Yeti. Wow, that'll be strong. That'll be so strong. Oh my god, that is so good. Okay. Do we coin into Yeti? Do we actually do this? Yeah, of course we do. We coin into Yeti and we hit face. He's most likely going to trade with his brewmaster into the knife juggler. Maybe he tried to whittle the Yeti down. Priest hates dealing with Yeti. He really does. Oh, we're playing against Messi, guys? Lionel Messi? The little Argentinian devil? The Pistolero? The Pipito? Oh, he has a Yeti too.
Yeti combo!
Okay, I'm gonna draw. And I'm going to coin. And I'm gonna hit coin, mirror image. And the reason I did this is because I want to be able to kill his Yeti at, like, in one go. And even if he has Holy Nova here, he still can't kill my Yeti. Well, he actually can kill my Yeti in one go. But he doesn't. He doesn't have it. He is starting to develop his board otherwise. Much stronger. So it looks like Yeti will actually be able to clean the board on his own. But, and this is a huge but, I like Yeti, so I don't want him to die. Come home, Yeti. You will be played another day. And he can play anything. Okay. Okay, well, that kind of... Oh, wow. Okay. Let's see. Can he kill... Yeah, he can kill Yeti, but, like... I think the play here is... Okay. I think the play here might actually still be Blizzard. It freezes the Silver Moon Guardian. And it kills off the other two. And then he has a really weak board after that. Or I can wait for him to play more things. But they can be big things. Alternatively, I can play the Yeti and then ping his Silver Moon. Forcing him to trade two of his minions with one Yeti. But then Blizzard kind of becomes useless in my hand. So I'm going to Blizzard. Some may disagree with this, but I'm going to Blizzard. Anyway, I don't care. Next play is... Oh, what happened to my screen? Did I just lose my cards to the... No, okay. That was Thought Steal. Thought Steal is pretty good for him. It's kind of like an Arcane Intellect, but from your opponent's deck. And he gets the Imp Master, that lucky bastardo. Okay. Flame Strike? No, Yeti. Yeti. More Yeti. I think I play the Injured Blade Master here. Yeah. I need to get as many hit points as I can on the board at the moment. It's not about the minions, it's about the hit points. And they both have 4 attack, so they kind of dodge... the power words. So he's gonna holy fire the Yeti. That's a big play. That is a really big play. He is gonna be the most sour of individuals when he sees the Yeti come down next turn. He's gonna be like, wow, dude. Wow, what a draw. Okay. Oh dear me. We are losing card advantage though, so this is a problem. We're starting to lose the card advantage, but this is a strong board. Especially against what he has. He just heals. I think he should trade with a minion, or he is going to. Oh! Wow. The tide has turned. The tide has turned, ladies and gents. Or has it now? So this guy goes into this guy. This guy pings this guy. This guy goes into this guy. And I have a tingly feeling inside that says duplicate is gonna get me Ysera this turn. Here we go, come on. Duplicate into Ysera, do it for me. Make it happen. Make it happen. Make it happen. Don't just heal and pass. Heal and pass. Okay. I guess I freeze the priest to the face. I mean, what else? What else can I do? Oh my goodness. Wait, what a minute. We have 10? 10, 12? You can kill him in 2 turns, I think. Oh my god, he stole a fireball from me. But, wait, why did I say duplicate Ysera? Why did I say that? It didn't make any sense. You guys must have been like, what? You mean Mirror Entity, you fool. Well, sorry guys, it's been a long day. I've been in, like, for the past 2 weeks, I've been literally stuck in traffic for at least 3 hours a day. So, like, you gotta give me a break. But 2 Frost Elemental at this stage in the game is kind of ridiculous. And there's no reason why I shouldn't just play everything I have now. There's no reason not to. If he draws a Holy Nova, great. Fine. We're fine. If he draws a Flame Strike, wow, another Holy Fire. So this guy is pulling a priest. He's pulling a priest. But sir, you're gonna be sour as balls. Because you will lose your guy to my Argent Squire. And I'm gonna draw more cards. Oh yeah, Ventrico is so good now. Oh man, such draws. Le value. Le value. Oh no! He stole the best one. Mind control tech heal. Like, I can't get him down. He keeps healing and stealing. Haha. That rhymed. Frostbolt that. Ping. Pew. Bam. And the reason I didn't play the Ventrico is because, 1, 4 hit point. 4 attack. And 2, I have other things in my hand. Why would I slow my... can't talk. Why would I slow myself down by playing the Ventrico now? I still have a board that is going to be okay against any sort of AoE. Okay, so he Shadow Words and he's gonna heal up. He's kinda holding on now. Oh, this is a good one. So I play that, I play this, and I ping. And now we need to go for the killing blow next turn. So you've been holding on long enough, Messi. Next turn will be your bane. Unless you draw, like... Yeah. GG. Well played. Game 2 is officially over. What's going on here? Did he rage quit? He might have rage quit. So I believe you had a grayed out fireworks screen. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Hearthstone Wednesdays. Remember to leave a like and a comment. Tell me what you think and call me a scrub about all the mistakes I might have made in this video. But hey, we got 2 wins. Look out for the next 3 battles next Wednesday. Thanks for watching, guys, and take care.